What's going on, everyone? Welcome to another KeyShot Quick Tip. In this video, we're going to jump into our advanced cloth materials and learn how to use RealCloth to create braided cable in KeyShot. The first step to successfully creating braided cable is making sure that the model you're working with is properly UV mapped. If the model does not have UVs, you will not be able to apply RealCloth to the model. Once your model is properly UV'd, add RealCloth by double-clicking on the material surface to open the Project Panel Material tab and select RealCloth from the Material Type dropdown. Then under the Weave Pattern dropdown, you can select any of the preset patterns to work with, but I typically go for the Basket 8x8 pattern when I'm creating a metal braided hose effect. You'll also want to make sure that the scale mode is set to UV, and depending on the size of your UVs, you may need to adjust the scale up or down to mimic the type of cable you're trying to recreate. The next thing to do is change your weave pattern's angle by scrolling down to the RealCloth material's advanced settings and then changing the geometry angle to match the appearance of the braided cable material you're mimicking. Once you have the general direction and scale set, you can now customize your braid to match the material you're trying to replicate. I'm creating a metal braid, so I'll go into my warp color and weft color settings and select a gray color for both using the color picker. I'll also set my warp roughness and weft roughness to 0 so the material has higher sheen and appears more metallic in nature. At this point, it's now time to start editing the warp and weft to look more like a metal mesh than a cloth material. I'll start by opening the Edit Weave Pattern window next to the Weave Pattern dropdown. From here, I'll adjust the width settings so there is less space between threads, and I'll change the thread shape from round to ribbon for both the warp and weft, and then select Apply. You'll immediately notice that the threads appear flatter and more reflective, but the material still doesn't have quite the level of refractivity of a metal braid. To exaggerate this, I'll go back to the advanced settings and increase my warp and weft refractive index until my material matches my vision for that braided cable. I also recommend making one slightly less refractive than the other to add a little bit of differentiation and realism to each of the thread directions. I'll then adjust the warp specular and weft specular to further exaggerate that difference, again making sure that one is slightly lighter in color than the other. Using KeyShot RealCloth will definitely help you create more realistic cable materials in your future projects, and as always, if you're interested in more useful KeyShot content, hit that subscribe button, give us a like, and don't forget to let us know your thoughts on this quick tip in the comment section below.